Hello viewers, welcome to African Act. I'm Janet Wainaina. I am at Freemasons Arms, and right here is the Society of Black Lawyers, who are celebrating Judge Peter HERBERT. And listening to him speak today and listening to other people speak today about how they have made many changes in the society because of their work together, advocacy, activism, and just knowing what changes you want to see. We're going to be hearing from a lot of people today, and more importantly, what I'm saying is listen to the speeches and think, what can you do to be part and parcel of those changes around you? Now, there's a lot of young people who want to get into the law society. There's a lot of young people who are saying they want to make changes in the community. And there's a lot of young people who are also saying that they're discriminated against. The question is, what can we do to empower each other? Who can we follow so as we can be as good as we want the society to be? So an association like the Society of Black Lawyers, Black Socks, has brought together so many lawyers, so many barristers, so many judges, people who are black and in the community doing their work professionally. The corporate world, when it comes to this judicial system, can be very daunting for a lot of young people. But to see an association like this, where they can network together, where they can share good words together, it means that for those who are joining in, you need to find out how you can be part and parcel of such an association, so as you can make those personal career changes, and also you can have network in your careers that would make a difference.
What I'd like to invite you to do to a roundup is individually, whatever fight you have, take it to the next level. Never surrender that territory, because the struggle we have is nothing to the struggle that our forefathers and ancestors had. Absolutely nothing. So for me, now, what is the future? The future is to make sure that our ancestors do not, are not given or forgotten in our struggle. And so for me, I feel their power here tonight. They are here with you. They are here in all of you that have spoken, all that you have listened. They are here, and you stand on their shoulders. Our world is not limited by London or Hampstead. It is a global world where we are the today and tomorrow, not the yesterday. So for me, I have an invitation and a challenge. I would like you all to come to Kenya in December 16th and 17th. Forget about Red List, but if it's there, we'll just postpone it and have it as other time. Those of you who have been to West Africa or not even been to Africa at all, I don't care, come. It's only like £490 on Kenya Airways. Circulate that black pound. You will stay in the finest hotels. You can jump up with Maasai or down with Maasai. December, please come. Whenever you want to come, you will be kings and queens, as you already are, but please, you're welcome. And let's do this Pan-African thing and make sure that what we do here is actually influences all our tomorrows. Can I thank you once again from the bottom of my heart? I'm sorry I hadn't mentioned anybody, my judicial colleagues who are still fighting the good fight, my colleagues in the police, my colleagues in just all our people. Thank you. And stay blessed, stay safe, and I love you all to bits. Thank you.
Viewers, it's such a beautiful time today, and we say we've had so many voices today, but your voice today was amazing. So introduce yourself and tell the people about you as a black lawyer in the UK and how you feel having worked with so many of them in the society.
Okay, I'm Leroy Logan. I'm a retired police officer. I did 30 years in the Met Police, and through that journey, I've been able to work with a lot of other lawyers of different backgrounds, but mainly through the Society of Black Lawyers and Peter HERBERT. And as a result of that, I even said in my speech how he inspired me, not only in bringing Johnny Cochran from the States and we having our Race for Justice conference, but he also was on the Met Police Authority. And he really shook up the Met, and it inspired us as part of the Black Police Association to do likewise, you know, through the Stephen Lawrence inquiry, the McPherson inquiry, and everything that we needed. So speak truth to power. And it's really great to, you know, work with other advocates in the justice system. You know, in Jamaica they say iron sharpens iron.
Yes.
And I really believe that's the case. And, you know, even in retirement, I retired in 2013, you know, we still are involved in the struggle for equality and justice and to hold public organizations more accountable.
But I mean, listening to you, you are legendary. I mean, you are somebody that young people would love to connect with and hear from as well, because not many are actually going into, you know, into policing. For some reason, there's such a they're lagging behind in joining in. What would be your message to young people if they really want to get into the police system or even the justice system to work there? What would you like to tell them?
Well, I'd like to say to any young person who's looking at the career path, there's no no-go area for advocacy. We need to have a reflective organization, whether it's in policing or in the wider justice system or any other public or private organization. They have to know their calling, respond to that, and don't be derailed by people's prejudices or practices or any sort of characters who try to take them off track. And, you know, they have to be very, very clear on what they want to do and take wise counsel. Choose their friends wisely. You know, the family should be there for them, the guardians. And, you know, we as advocates can be called upon. You know, we're not in isolation. We're still part of the struggle. We're still in grassroots organizations. And I'd like to think we're accessible. So call on us.
It is be part of a community. Be part of an association.
That, you know,
somewhere.
Unity in the community, working together in a way that there's no barriers. We're there to help our young people to learn from our experiences and to do even better. So I'll call on them. If it's your calling, whatever it may be, policing or otherwise, respond to that calling, and we are there to support you internally with the Black Police Association or the Society of Black Lawyers or the Association of Black Probation Officers, whatever it may be. And we'll be there externally, even in retirement. I'm busier now than I was in the Met.
Yes.
So that shows you we've still got our hands, you know, to the plow.
Well, young people and everybody out there, you've heard about that profile. Mr. Logan here is talking to you about what we can do as a community. And more importantly, advocacy is not for some people, it's for everybody. Be part and parcel of the changes you want to see.